Hi there, this is Jonas Bergquist from the Collaborative Research Center at Uppsala University, Sweden, and I'm also the Chief Medical Officer of Open Medicine Foundation. So I've been asked to comment a bit on the LIFT trial that we just launched, and this is a collaborative effort together with David Systrom's research groups at the Mass General Brigham Hospital or Harvard University. And we, as you know, we are now trying to evaluate the combination of treatment with Mestinon or Pyridostigmine together with low-dose naltrexone treatment in ME/CFS patients. We are very happy that we have now managed to get all the way to launching the study, and we will do it as a four-armed, double-blind, placebo-controlled trial. So in this case, 40 patients will get placebo, 40 patients will get a low-dose naltrexone treatment, 40 patients will get Mestinon only, and then 40 patients will get both Mestinon and LDN treatment in combination. We won't know who get what. That will be revealed after the study is over, so it's double-blinded to make sure that we don't get biased by the reports from the patients. So a question that came in to us is what molecular assessments are going to be done during the trial. And we will collect blood sample and urine before and during and after the treatment. And we will then monitor molecular features in these biosamples. We will do proteomics, that is in-depth protein analysis. We will do metabolomics, which is small molecules monitoring. We will do both targeted and screening methodologies. In the proteomics, we will do mass spectrometry-driven proteomics with high-resolution mass spectrometry. With immunoassays, we will do targeted analysis of certain cytokines, that is immune cell signaling molecules. In the urine and plasma samples, we will also do metabolomics using both mass spectrometry, but also NMR, that is nuclear magnetic resonance analysis. So we then get a full profile of the metabolomic changes that may occur in the patients during the treatment. How the changes within functional capacity is going to be measured, it will be measured by a survey that is called FunCap27. That's a new survey that's been developed by Norwegian colleagues, Christian Sommerfeldt and colleagues. And we are very happy to be first out testing this new questionnaire. It's based on 27 well-tailored questions that the patients will respond on, and that we do that on a regular manner. So we will have responses before the treatment starts, during the treatment with frequent every week measures, and then after the treatment is over. And we hope that this will respond well to how the patients feel their functionality is changing, and also give us an insight into what part of their functions and symptoms are affected by the different treatments. In combination with this questionnaire, we will also ask the patients to carry one of these portable devices. It's a Garmin device that will record all the vital parameters, activity, blood measures, core activities like stress levels, heart rate variability, etc., etc. And this will be a very objective measure for us, and we can then correlate that to the symptoms, responses in the questionnaires, but also to general change in activity when it comes to response on the different treatments. We will also look at the synergetic effect of these two medications, so LDN and Mestinon in combination. We know that they have some different working mechanisms, but we are pretty convinced that in combination they could affect, for instance, brain fog and also pain, and hopefully will also help patients with activation. So the synergetic effect will be very much of interest for us to see how well that works. And the trial will run for 3 months. And we think that's very important also that we maintain the treatment for such a long time in order to secure the long-term effect of the treatment. Question, second question is, how do we think the clinical trial like the LIFT will affect the life of ME/CFS patients and potentially also for long COVID patients? Well, we think one of the fundamental parts is, of course, how well the treatments work. But in order to make sure that we get objective measures for that, it's important to do this kind of double-blinded placebo-controlled studies. And the combination of the molecular features that we will measure in the blood samples and the urine samples collected during the trial will also help us to understand why certain patients respond and why certain patients do not respond to certain treatments. And this can help us in the long stage, long-term perspective, to actually select and subdivide patients for different coming trials. Third question is, what makes Open Medicine Foundation's approach to research and clinical trials one of a kind? Well, we are very proud that we are being able now to launch this first trial, but we are hoping that this will be one out of a long line of trials and tests that we will launch in the coming years. We have been working very close together with the patients and looked at patient surveys to get an insight into what kind of treatments been tested and what has had some positive effects on certain subgroups of patients. And we, based on this, we have made a very great in detail selection of potential targets for our trials. And we hope this is going to be a positive way of and a fruitful way of reaching fast progressive clinical research trials. It's very important for us to make sure that the drugs that we are selecting for our trials are available for large communities. So we will focus on already approved drugs initially and make efforts to make sure that the trials will show of efficacy and will be helping a lot of patients on a global perspective. And the fourth question is, how can the open medicine community help accelerating research? Well, of course, we are extremely grateful for your support, for your insights, and for your willingness to share your own treatments, efficacies, etc. That helps us a lot when it comes to selecting good targets for our trials. But of course, also your general supportive efforts, your positive responses to our questionnaires, and also your willingness to share and to help us in our research efforts. And of course, the support to Open Medicine Foundation is the base for any of our trials. So that is something that we are also very, very grateful for. So thank you very much. I hope I answered some of your questions, and hope to see you soon somewhere.